talking as Mhlali wasemthonjo noDlamini. To speak on the struggles in response to the impact of neoliberalism on access to public goods. I really find it the topic very challenging for me to speak on it. It consists of big ways, neoliberalism. I'm struggling to unpack that. But in a way then, as Mhlali wasemthonjo, I am going to make sure that, or I'm going to try to attach myself on the ground in terms of trying to unpack this big word. Before, you know, I talk about the impact of neoliberalism. For me, I find it very difficult to move without talking about the legacy of the apartheid. Because currently, our people have been moved within the cities to the outskirts of the cities, and as a result of that, our people ended up residing within informal settlement. And of course, then there was a struggle in terms of defeating the apartheid system in South Africa, and part of that was through mass-based activities. And as a result of that, until then, a time for our first democratic national election took place. Then from there, we did have a democracy in South Africa, and where a very seemed to be progressive economic policy, which was introduced, the RDP, but 2 years later, you know, it was replaced by another apartheid system, you know, or by another apartheid-based economic policy, which is the GEA policy. I find it very, very difficult in terms of identifying the difference between the GEA or between the capitalism and the apartheid system. Because if you look at the impact of that, or if you look at the impact of neoliberalism, it led to privatization, it led to job losses, it led to water cut-off, and it led to electricity cut-off. And as a result of that, there's been ways in which people on the ground have tried to respond in this impact of water privatization, where people's water have been cut off, where people's electricity have been cut off. And of course, then there have been also two ways in terms of responding to that. There are people who have been responding with a clear analysis in terms of identifying the enemy. And the people on the ground who have been reactionary, or who have been reacting on the water cut-off, who have been reacting on the electricity cut-off without having a clear understanding of the root cause of the problem or of the enemy. Those who have a clear ability to analyze the enemy have came up with a constructive way of engaging with the system, where we've seen a number of court struggles taking place, where people have been challenging, you know, certain policies, where submissions but through different committees have been made. And also, you know, when looking at those that didn't have the ability in terms of identifying or analyzing the enemy, then those are those who have been reactionary, where we've seen people on the ground trying to reconnect the water which has been disconnected, and in other areas where people have also tried to redistribute the electricity or trying to connect the electricity for themselves. I don't want to use the term stealing the electricity, but rather, you know, then use the term, you know, redistributing of the electricity. The problem is, you know, once you begin, you know, to talk about stealing of the electricity, then the people that, you know, will say, you know, an order must take its place, you know. So I'm running, you know, I'm trying to run away, you know, from those terms. And of course, then, you know, people who are directly affected are still having difficulties in terms of distinguishing between the ANC and the policies that the ANC government is implementing. And if you look at the example of the province, which is very dynamic, the Western Cape, where the Democratic Alliance is in power, and where people on the ground, where are experiencing the water cut off, the electricity cut off, the evictions, and people are thinking that it is the DA-led policies that lead to, these things. And they think that the only solution to that is to replace the DA government with an ANC government, forgetting that if you replace the ANC government with the DA government, or you replace the ANC government with the DA government, it's like, you know, you're just like voting to change the driver of the same bus. That it is within the view of Abahlali baseMjondolo of the Western Cape that the direction also that the Conference for Democratic Left need to take, it need to respect the different ways of organizing. And with there shouldn't be anybody, any organizations that tries to impose ways of struggling to different organizations.